Today we're going to take you through an unboxing of the EKMR20WT, which is white in color, AM FM MP3 radio, and we've also got the silver in color. This is the EKMR20SL. So when we receive the unit, we're going to open up the box and packaging. First thing that we got popping out over here is our instruction manual and warranty card information. We'll be going through that in depth. We've got our universal mounting strap, hardware, and uninstall keys, also extremely necessary. We'll be going through that in more depth. We've got the body of the radio, and we've got our essential wiring harnesses. Let's get straight to the bottom of the, to the body of the radio itself. Body of the radio, you notice extremely shallow, only about 4 inches in depth. Makes it ideal for a lot of different installs. Shallow depth, not a problem. You know, extremely lightweight, extremely durable, and we've got all our basic connections. It's important to mention that this unit is a mech-free radio, meaning that there's no CD mechanism. Your main operations with this radio is going to be your AM FM, which is standard. You've got an SD card port, which is marine covered. You've got a USB jack, which also has its own marine cover. And you've got a 3.5 millimeter or 1/8 inch iPod input jack for use with cell phones, iPods, tablets, any device that has a headphone line audio output jack. We've got our input ISO DIN plugs for our power and speaker harnesses. We've got our rear threaded bolt for our installation. For our installation strap, this allows you to secure the back of the radio to the dashboard or to the housing to make sure it's sturdy in the back to enjoy effortless, skipless audio. We've got our RCA connections, which are required for the addition of an aftermarket amplifier. Red being for right side audio, white being for left side audio. And we've got our essential AM FM female terminal connection, which most marine radios, they'll plug in with a single connection and you're ready to go with all your local AM FM band stations. Here we've got the uninstall keys and we've got the mounting strap. Now the mounting strap, we're gonna go back to this threaded bolt area. A lot of people overlook this, but it's still very required. It allows the radio to be fit into the dashboard without any issues. We would unthread that bolt, secure this down, and bend or secure this, and thread the opposite side to the dash or to the brace to make sure that everything is secured and locked in. So when you receive the radio, you're going to notice that the trim ring is already going to be pre-installed. We want to unclip that trim ring, which comes off with very little pressure along the bottom. We're going to insert the uninstall keys on the left and right sides of the radio. Got that one inserted. Got this one inserted. And now we should just be able to pull back on the body of the radio itself in order to get it off of the actual ring itself. This allows us to get to the mounting chassis support that if we pre-install this in the dashboard, we could bend down these tabs and push these tabs in to form a nice tight secure lock within the dashboard. So it's not gonna budge, it's not gonna move when it's installed in the vehicle. I'm gonna take you through the ISO DIN plug for the speaker lead output harness. This particular radio has a 60 watt by 4, which is a 240 watt total output jack. So you're gonna see a pair of color-coded wires. You'll have a pair of purple, a pair of gray, a pair of white, and a pair of green. So each set of wires is gonna have a solid tone wire, like this solid color purple. This is going to control an individual speaker lead. So purple is gonna be your rear right positive speaker polarity. And the rear right negative is going to be the purple with the negative stripe. We would make those connections directly to those speakers and we'd receive our audio output. Then we're going to go into our gray and gray and black. The gray is going to be our front right speaker, positive polarity. Gray with a black stripe is going to be our negative polarity for the front right speaker. This brings us to our white and white and black. The white connection is going to be our front left speaker, positive polarity. And white with a black stripe is going to be our front left negative speaker polarity. Then we've got our green, green and black. Solid green is going to be our rear left speaker polarity, positive, and a rear left negative speaker polarity connection. These ISO DIN plugs plug in securely on the rear of the radio. You'll notice that the speaker lead connections will plug in over in the top connection, and they quickly disassemble if you push in on the corner and slide out. You'll almost feel the locking mechanism when it comes into play. The power lead connections easily lock into the back, give you that same locking and connection. So you could pre-wire each one of these harnesses as we just went through, and then save your last connection for plugging it into the rear. Once everything is pre-wired, it goes back together the same way it came apart. We basically just take the body of the radio, slide it back into the chassis, push it all the way in. You should almost hear those two clicks, and it's locked down and secure. It's not going to go anywhere. Then we can reattach the cosmetic trim ring, and we have a nice clean install.